everyone, we just finished the keynote section. Did you attend the keynote?
I didn't get a chance to see this keynote.
It was supposed to be really good. I didn't either, so we'll have to live stream it later. With me is former New York teacher. I guess you're always a teacher. You never really get rid of that.
Absolutely.
But you're also with Bright Bites. Can you tell us a little bit about Bright Bites and why you're here?
Yeah, so we work with states and school districts and service agencies to help measure the impact that technology has on learning. And so NiceGate's a great place for us to talk with the people we're already working with, like Lyric and the districts in kind of the southern part of the state, and then meet new folks to work with.
Tell us about, you were part of Startup yesterday, and tell us your role. You're a mentor.
Yeah, absolutely. So Startup Weekend is a wonderful opportunity for educators and designers and developers to get together and think through what kinds of innovations we need in education and try to actually create a startup in 54 hours. And I had done that when I was a teacher in Seattle and formed a team and was able to win the competition and then have kind of mentored people through the process since then. And it's just an amazing opportunity. For me, it was less about the specific product that we were thinking about and more about the innovation process. You know, how can you take an idea from the inception of that idea to actually working with developers to code out and create UI for it and then figure out a business model that will help support that and then iterate on that idea over and over again. And then I actually did that with my students, which is a really powerful experience as well.
What are you looking to get out of NiceGate Conference?
I think for me, it's all about relationships. I've had an amazing opportunity to talk with people from every level of the organization within New York State, people who are teachers, people who are within the district as district technology officers, people within the service agencies, and it's just been an awesome opportunity to meet some really incredibly smart people and have great education conversations.
What do you, crystal ball, what do you think is coming down the line for education and technology?
So for me, I think we're at a stage now where we've seen a lot of education technology that takes what we have been doing in the classroom and substitutes for it and kind of automates those processes, and I think that's great. It makes things more efficient and effective, but I think we've yet to see things that have had a really huge impact on instruction in the classroom, especially in ways that we know are more student-centered. And so I think over the course of the next 5 years or so, we're going to start to see technologies, instructional technologies in the classroom that are able to really better understand how students learn best and support teachers in doing what we know is great teaching and learning, as opposed to substituting for test prep and things like that.
Oh, I see Teresa.
I'm going to kind of maybe bounce back and think about the startup concept. What do you think about the blending that happens at startup with entrepreneurs and education? Do you think that's, how does that benefit both, I guess?
Absolutely. So I think when I've gone to some startup weekends, you've seen educators who come, like I did the first time, who've been in these great conversations and dialogues where you can kind of spin your wheels forever and you don't have the skills to actually bring it to fruition. And so you have great ideas, but you don't know how to actually make them happen. And then I've met entrepreneurs and people from the business community who have the skills to transform an idea into a business, but they don't know the education space. And so they come in with ideas from outside that may be well-intentioned but misguided. And so from an education perspective, we've seen plenty of technologies that have come through the classroom like that. I certainly have taught with them and been forced to teach with them. So it's really important to have that intervention where you can have a conversation with educators and entrepreneurs together.
Great. All right, it's time for our speed geek questions. So these are quick, short answers. Go ahead and hit the green button. We'll spin the dial. Once again. There we go. Star Wars or Star Trek?
Beautiful. I was actually watching or listening to Pop Culture Happy Hour where they had a whole discussion about this the other day. I fall on the Star Wars side because I grew up watching it with my dad, but I also have love for Star Trek.
Okay. So a little of both.
Yep.
Mac, PC, or Chromebooks?
Oof. Okay. Hard choice. I think it depends on the implementation you're trying to do. For me, I am a big fan of the possibility of Chromebooks, because I think that they can be a less expensive alternative, but I think there's value to all of them.
Okay, one more. Oh. You do it one more time.
Still Star Wars.
Yeah. Favorite social network?
For me, it's Twitter. I've learned so much through Twitter, and I've been able to make such amazing connections and then meet people in real life. I think for me, that's been by far the biggest value add is Twitter.
I agree. All right, Mike Klein, thank you very much.
So nice to talk to you.
We'll see you around.
Thanks.
Bye-bye.